Hi, I'm Chad Nolan with Future Point of View, and I just got to say that I'm very excited to cover this series called Modernizing the Digital Backbone. It's such a crucial framework that a lot of organizations don't seem to really follow or understand, and I want to really kind of uncover really what this all entails. So when we say digital backbone, what that really means is it's not just the technologies that make you money that we're talking about. We're talking about the people and the processes as well, because they too are investments. So go a little bit further and unpack people, process, and technology. Let's start with the people first, right? So we're talking about the subject matter experts, the SMEs, right? The people that know the processes very well from a day in, day out perspective and get things done. You have to have those people identified first. Not to mention, you got to have the stakeholders, right? Those that will essentially kick off and trigger any input into a process and ultimately consume the output, right, as consumers to a process, as well as any kind of steering committee. If that's a new concept to you, there's all types of committees out there. Steering committee keeps you on track with technologies and making sure that it's in alignment with the business strategy. There's also something we call ABOs. Those are application business owners, right? This is a concept that really is taking on, especially with all the SaaS solutions and cloud solutions that we have today, where it's not so much IT's responsibility to maintain and keep up with the longevity of the application, but more so on the business side, somebody's got to own that, right? So that's the people. From the process side, we'll start with capabilities. The capabilities for the business are what it does, right? So if you're an insurance provider and maybe you do claims administration, that's the what. Now, the process is the how. It's how you get things done. So if you have a business capability that is claims administration, how you get some of that done would be to do possibly adjudication of claims or incident response of a claim, right? So it's the how things are getting done. And then ultimately you have a value stream. That's essentially all the processes that where you go through and take all the waste out, all the inefficiencies, and have a clear value stream to the customer. So they're getting the best of you and the process itself. And then we have the technology, which is really the core technology investments. We're talking about the applications, the platforms. We're talking about the integrations, data analytics, everything that you use from a true platform application and system perspective. Not to mention all of the standards and IT capabilities that have to support the overall business capability perspective. So going through this, we're going to go through several stages, right? If we look at stage one, this is where you have to set the fertile ground. We call this identify and strategize, right? So when we talk about identify, we're talking about identifying those business capabilities. We're talking about identifying who's doing what with what technology, right? We're also covering a little bit of the strategy piece. We're thinking about, okay, where do we fall from a digital maturity perspective? Where are some of our issues or opportunities and how we can make things better and essentially get a digital strategy that is in alignment with our overall business strategy. Next, we're going to focus on stage two, what we call memorialize and realize. You know, they say that pictures are 1,000 words, and I'm a true believer in that. And when we talk about memorialization of your current state environment, we're talking about your processes, right? We're talking about the people that are actually performing these steps and looking at the technologies that are actually being used in each step of the process, and something that we can use as a visual language that anybody can understand, right? Same thing with the actual technologies involved. Anything that is captured, that captures data or moves data around, that is part of your enterprise application architecture that we have to actually cover. And having that kind of iconography and visual language will really allow you to see, you know, where are some of the gaps we have with you know, with data, with people, with processes. Next, in stage three, we're going to talk about solutioning and really trying to modernize this, the overall backbone. So in this series, we're going to be talking about things more in the light of a SaaS solution. So we're going to go through the process of selecting software as a service. And we're not just talking about selecting a platform, we're actually talking about selecting a vendor. Right, so you have to consider that also. So when you go to the solution and modernize, we're going to be talking about actually going through doing an RFP, how to write a world-class RFP, how to get the requirements, right, from all the process mapping that was done and looking at the issues, the shortcomings, the opportunities that we have, and actually going out and getting a really good vendor and narrowing down that and being able to really measure it against the status quo if we did do nothing today, right? We're talking about doing the actual demos with a vendor, right? Making sure that they're not just telling you, hey, we can do this, but they're showing you how they can do this with the day in the life of your company and with your processes. Then we're gonna follow up with stage four, which is actually implementing and monetizing, right? So making sure that you have a good implementation team, as well as focusing on some pre-implementation steps before you even get into the implementation is key. Like making sure your data is in good shape before you start trying to migrate it into a new location. Those kinds of things that are very, very important to do to make sure that you can monetize and continue that to go to have a good implementation to get in scope, on time, and in budget. And then the last section we're going to cover is called evolution management. Evolution management is a new organizational change management. There's just something about asking someone to change or to change a process that can be taken probably not the best way. You know, asking someone to evolve, it's not so much of a fad or a knee-jerk reaction. It's got some substance and some meaning to it. So we're going to cover a little bit on this evolution management because think about it, when you're asking someone to, hey, we're going to migrate to a new cloud solution, and that's going to impact people's lives, going to impact, you know, processes. We have to really think about this and get our cadence right. And we see it time after time where, you know, where CEOs come to us and say, you know, wow, I dumped hundreds of thousands of dollars into this project. I have nothing to show for, right? You know, there's things that we're not getting done. We haven't even got the implementation done. And so you have to use this evolution management as you go. In leadership, we're really counting on you to make sure that that happens, right? So that would conclude the series. So, but we're really looking forward to getting your feedback as well. And so we're going to be using a tool called Immersive. And we're going to have some questions out there that we're going to ask you and ask you to participate. And we love getting your feedback and just, you know, asking you, how do you do modernization, and what are some of the things that you know that you want to include in your framework as well? So stay tuned for the rest of the series, and we're looking forward to seeing you.